Hello guys, this is Christian, and I will now show you what are the BACnet configurations available to you with Wacnet. The first step is to go into the section named BACnet configs. The two first configs are there if you encounter a very slow MSTP network. If it's the case, you can increase the timeouts. However, I will say that the three first configurations are there mostly for BACnet experts. You should never change them unless you know exactly what you are doing. So for most of you, you should disregard these three configurations. The broadcast address is automatically chosen with your network configurations, which means you shouldn't have to change it unless you have more than a single network interface. We'll come back to this later. The port is the port of your BACnet network. By default, it's 47808. There are some cases where you might require more than a single BACnet network. Usually, in those cases, the next port chosen is 47809, 47810, and so on. So most of the time, the default, 47808, is the one you want to stick with. The device ID is the most important configuration. On every BACnet network, only one device can have a given ID. In our case, Wacnet is using the ID 1338. This means that no other device on the entire network can have the same ID. If you think you might be in the same range as other devices on your network, just pick something much farther away, something like 10,000. And now the local interfaces, which are directly linked to the broadcast address, as mentioned before. Here you can see WLAN 0. This is my wireless interface. If I add another interface, say an Ethernet wire plugged in, I would see it there, along with its IP address and broadcast address. So the broadcast address field enables you to choose on which interface to send the broadcast. If your BACnet network is connected with the Ethernet wire, then you should enter the broadcast address associated with it. And this is it. With these simple configurations, you should be able to connect to all BACnet IP networks.